away.
Yes.
Glory to God. Because what you call me, God calls small.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So I'm expecting God to be. I'm not expecting my name. I'm expecting God to be.
Yes.
So I'm praising God for God to be. Not my name. Because you think you got a big situation going on. You think you in something. You don't know your way to come out. But you know God said, I'm going to do something for you. It's way bigger than you. It's way bigger than somebody else say, that ain't nothing to God.
Wait!
y'all think you're a pastor, but I'm still shocked you ain't bad. Because what you got on your own. You better go to work, buddy.
Yes, yes, amen. Hallelujah.
You better do what you got to do. I'm going to God, boo. I'm still praising. But I ain't taken up and tied up in what I got to do. I'm a surrender.
Amen.
Is your God?
Yes.
Hit it with you. My hand off. And I'm going to praise you. Hallelujah. Sometimes I praise just to let him know my hand's off. Nobody will be you. Nobody but me and you. Nobody but me and you. I come to the point that the woman with issue of blood, I said, nobody but me and him. Me alone. Because I'm gonna blame you. been doing this, but I should have been doing this. And I'm listening to you, and I did what you want me to do, but I should have been in the presence of God. Calling on the name of Jesus.
The Lord is where you're supposed to be. That's where the Lord is at.
Thank you, Jesus.
something and you ain't there on time. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, y'all. He'll tell you that you ain't looking at God's time. On the street, God ordered. Tell them God ordered this. God put everything in order. Because you know I'm going to confuse this. He knows what's going to come up in my life. So God orchestrated the time in an order. See, God is God order, ain't he? He said, I'm not the author confused, so he's God order. So God ordered this for me to be in praise. Every situation, every circumstance, the word will come just on time right now. The word going to come right when I need. Whoop. The word going to be preached on the pulpit from right when I need. Whoop. God will bring a word of revelation going to come to me. Right there on time. Right when I need it the most. It's going to be right there on time. Because that's when God on the strength. See, this ain't no confusion. God orchestrated this right here. And when you ain't in place to get what you need, to speak what you need. I got to get what I need to speak what I need. Amen. I need to speak what I need. I don't miss it. Amen. Didn't say all that fell short. Amen. You miss God's time. Jesus. You miss God's time. For their time. He always said that. That's why he said, give it all and follow me. Did you tell him that? Amen. You can't give it all. You ain't ready. You ain't ready to follow him. Because you can't give up all. You can't give up the children. You can't give up nothing. Y'all ain't said that. I keep it all in here. But when God orders you, be somewhere on time, he'll be. Y'all ain't said that. See, it's an order. See, it's an order. See, an order. It's an order. This ain't just no church thing. This ain't no just no coming together on Sunday. God ordered this. He ordered before the foundation of the world. He set this up. Because you're dealing with some things right now, and you need a God over. So God knows you need a God move. So God orchestrated this, but right on time when you need a God move. See, you know you need a God move now. See, every time you need a God move, you know that right now. Because Lord came too many times. And if you don't get a God move. Y'all know how? But I check things out, I ain't got. Amen. I can't talk the way I live. Yes. Y'all ain't saying that. I can't talk the way I live. I can't bow myself out of this. I can't dress myself out of this. Amen. I can't weave myself out of this. Amen. I can't keep myself out of this. Amen. I ain't got nothing more. Amen. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. So I can't bargain. Right. You in a situation where you can't bargain.
That's right, amen.
You have nothing to bargain with. That's when you need a God move.
Yes.
See, you can't call yourself and give it to you at the end of the month. Because they don't want to hear it.
Right.
You ain't got nothing to bargain for.
Amen.
Oh, my God. You can't call them and tell them, I want to make a half a baby. This is enough.
Amen.
He ain't got nothing to bother with. On your job, you say, look here, I need to come in some extra hours to make some extra hours because I got this thing come up. They say, no, we don't need you. You can't bother with them. So your bargaining tool is gone. God.
Amen.
And God said, you need a God.
Amen.
He said, now, let me read my scripture. Now is the time for you to get crazy for me.
Amen.
Because right now, a border can't open.
Yeah.
Because this is the seat. Come on. I'm going to blow
it.
I'm going to say Porter. And I'm going to read my scripture. And I'm going to tell you, God always deal with those. All through scripture, God always deal with those. a way in. Y'all say, say a way in.
A way in.
It's a way in now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. But say, God got to open the door, but don't God overcame no man.
Amen.
Don't God close, can't no man open.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, God can open the door.
Hallelujah.
face over there. And then what? And then touch your face. Don't wear yours if you like that one.
Complete now.
See, I know what God's gonna do. I know God's gonna bless me. I know God's gonna go with that. He said, God told him, see, he looked at signs of the line. He had to wait on God, said, wait on God. So God told him, said, it's time to come to the point. I know what you did before. You've been dealing on it, been doing bad, but you just still, oh, come on somebody. But now it's time for you to let go and let God. Now when you let go, let see God move. Go read the verses.
For thee have I seen righteous before me in this generation.
Uh-huh. It's wicked out there.
Yeah.
It's bad out there.
Yeah.
Praise God, even the cashier treat you bad. When you spend your money. He get bad when that don't treat you bad. You know they got bad. It don't move down Burger King. You get mad. Ain't no good. The customer don't want the rat no more. The cashier right. Come on, son. I'm mad when people don't want to eat no bread. Help me, somebody. Don't you just came out of school. They're still ready to cut your lights off.
Right.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? I don't care about it. None. All they want what they want. Say
hallelujah.
But God said, now it's time for you to come on in. Because now you see what's out there. We get out there. It's time for you to come on in to the Lord. I told people, I said, come on, time for you to go to church and give God praise and go through this portal. I don't care what you've been doing. You need to go to church and give God some praise and give Him glory. Because why God said, the first shall be last and the last shall be first. Come on, somebody. You need to go and God bless you. And give God some praise and give Him the glory. And come and give God some time. Because it's time to come from out there.
Yes.
It's time to leave everything that ain't able. Yes. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm leaving it all up now. But God going to take care of me.
Amen.
Come on, read the rest of what it said.
Of every clean thing, thou shalt take to thee thyself.
Mm-hmm. Right.
The male and the female.
Uh-huh.
And of the beasts that are not clean by two. Mm-hmm. The male and his female. A fowl also of their air by self. The male and the female.
Y'all heard that? Say myself.
Myself.
Now, notice God's letter of completion.
Yes.
Now, you don't need to take the dirty stuff. But look at the word clean. Did he say clean?
Yes.
So, you don't need to take all those dirty thoughts with you.
Yes.
You need to take some clean stuff.
Yes.
And them things that happen in your past. And them things that happen in your life. He said, I need you to take the clean.
Yes.
See, because it's going to be a long journey. When you come through this door, I might bless you next week. But I might, like, you got to know I'm going to bless you next year. Your blessing is coming. No matter how long it takes, you got to know your blessing is coming. But if you come dirty, you don't want to jump off the boat. You ain't going to be able to make this church dirty when I send the rain out. If you don't come back with a leaf, you're going to get mad. But I need you to have a clean conscience and a clean mind. I need you to make up your mind that you're going to believe God. You're going to trust God